Chef Mommy in the house.
I wanted to take this time to show you a quick appetizer. I know lots of us are having parties and having people over to your house, so here's something quick and easy that you can do that is so packed full of flavor and just amazingly delicious, okay? So what I want to share with you tonight is an appetizer that you'll need about 11 slices of bread. You can pick whatever bread you like. The ones that I recommend and that are safe for my kids are the sliced bread at Whole Foods. I like the sourdough loaf. And I also just like the regular wheat bread, whatever one that you can tolerate, or whatever kind of bread that floats your boat. Go for it. We're gonna make like little BLT kind of sandwiches, but they're gonna be a little bit loftier than the sandwich. We'll call them a crostini, okay? So what I've done so far is to, and you can get as creative as you like with this, I took some of my cookie cutters and I cut out a snowman. You can't really see. And I did the one that's my favorite, is a Christmas tree out of the bread. Or you can just cut cubes if you want to save bread. You can cut cubes or you can do circles. It's really whatever makes you happy, right? So you're going to need some vegan mayo. And there's several different brands that you can choose from. There's one that doesn't have soy. There's one that's made with grapeseed oil. There's tons of options. So just some store-bought veggies, and you're gonna put 2/3 cup in your food processor. Fresh garlic cloves in there. And then I have 2 cups of fresh basil. You can find basil year round in the grocery store. What I do
and just mix it until it looks like a pesto.
A vegan or vegan version of bacon that you like. Now, I was at the grocery store, went to the wrong place, and then it had my favorite. My favorite for this recipe that I recommend is the Light Life Tempeh Bacon. It is incredible. And I didn't keep them as strips. I recommend cooking them, and then you can crumble them up and put them on top of this. Or if you like them in strips, you can do that too. Whatever floats your boat. So you want to spoon the basil up on the bottom of your toast or of whatever you choose. And it ends up being really, really pretty too. And then you want to have some little cherry. I have some cherry tomatoes that are sliced. And I have this bacon, so I'm gonna take the bacon. Since this bacon is a little bit different, I'm just gonna put a piece of bacon on it. And then I'm gonna put some tomatoes on it. And then you wanna save a little bit of the basil. And there you have it. Really quick, fun appetizer that is full of flavor and so dang on yummy. The Christmas season is all about having faith, all about believing. Oftentimes when Jesus would heal people in the Bible, before he'd heal them, he always asked them, "Do you believe?" So this next song that we're going to sing for you, I hope it encourages you during this season especially and always to believe.
Dried tears that wet Morning. I'm sleepy and I'm on my way to Charlie's school to bring some cookies. Christmas cookies that I showed you guys that I made. I hope the kids like them. What usually happens is that they don't care what's in them. It's as long as they're sweet and they look, you know, pretty, then the kids want to eat them, and then no one feels left out. No one ever knows that they don't have eggs or milk or nuts or that they're missing out on anything. Now, I haven't tried a bunch of gluten-free stuff yet, but I am going to be trying some gluten-free cookies to see how kids respond to them. I'll keep you guys posted.
How much fun it's gonna be together. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright. We're caroling through the night.
Hey, it's me, Chef Mommy, and I am busy. I just got my cards in the mail. So I'm sending out holiday cards and packing gifts for the teachers. Clark, are you showing all of this chaos around me? You can move it around and show everything.
Yes, chaos.
There's even some food, a plate of food on the floor.
Which Charlie would not eat.
Yes.
Nerdy ate all my food.
So this is just a part of the holiday rush for us. Merry Christmas.
Oh, look at the one. That's a wrap. And literally, it's time for me to wrap these staircases with some garland. So, I'm coming down with the garland. And although it's almost Christmas, it's still not over until you fully deck the halls. That's it. From my family to yours, I want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year. See you real soon. Here's another fave of mine. I don't know if I showed you this one already. Fa la 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 la. Fa la 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 la. Deck the halls with balls of corn. Fa la 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 la. Ho ho ho. What? Wait a minute, you're not Santa? What do you mean, ho, ho, ho? Oh, a tin hut? Merry Christmas!